Good morning, Vandana. Okay, let us start with some question. Let's consider some signal x of t equals to cos 2 pi f t. For example, this is some sound signal, single tone sound signal. We have one single frequency in this sound signal. Let's assume that we are generating sound from this source, some source x of t we are generating, and let's assume that this is my receiver. This is my x of t, and this is ground, reflected by ground. Let's assume like that. See, ground reflection. The sound can be reflected by ground or surface, right? Reflected by earth or ground. See, direct line of sight component, the reflected component. Just for basic understanding, let's consider that this is x of t minus tau. This one is x of t, this one is x of t minus tau without attenuation. I assume that reflection coefficient is 1, but generally that's not true. This might be less than 1 in general, it will be less than 1 because some absorption will be there, right? And you can't expect everything will be reflected this way, right? And what will be my received signal y of t? I am receiving this signal in two paths. One path I am receiving x of t, by another path I am receiving x of t minus tau. Then what is my y of t? Yes, you can answer. What is y of t? Is it addition or is it multiplication? What is that? Yes, what is my y of t? That received signal. You can answer, right? I am transmitting some signal. This is x of t I am receiving. In this path, I am receiving x of t minus tau. As a receiver, both are getting added, right?
Yes, sir.
Y of t will be x of t plus x of t minus tau, where tau is extra delay, right? As compared to this path, there is some extra delay because this path is somewhat longer, right? This path is a bit shorter. In general, for sound wave, what is the velocity in free space? Sound velocity. Yes, you can answer, right? What is the velocity of sound in free space? Okay, I'll ask, at least you can pick one of them. Is it
340?
Okay, 340 meters per second. Okay. Is it true or this one is true? Which one is true? 340 meters per second or 310.8 meters per second? Which one is true?
340 meters per second.
This is sound, right? This corresponds to electromagnetic signal transmission, that velocity. In free space, 310.8. This is sound waves, air pressure, the traveling of that air pressure variations, right? 340 meters per second. Then what will be my delay? Let's assume that this path length is d and this path length is b1. Then what is my tau in this case? Is any guess? The extra time taken for me, right? Extra time taken for me is nothing but tau equals to d1 minus d divided by v, right? I am having this much extra path to travel this wave, right? d1 minus d is the extra path distance, extra path length I am having. D1 minus D divided by V. This much corresponds to my delay tau, excess delay as compared to this reference path. Now what will happen to this one? Cos 2 pi f into t, this is my x of t, plus x of t minus tau means cos 2 pi f into t minus tau. Let's call this like x of t and call this like x of t minus tau. And this is my y of t, received signal. Then what is this in the frequency domain? Y of f equals to, can you just tell me impedance of x of f? This is x of f plus, if I apply Fourier transform on both sides, then what is the Fourier transform for this? E power minus j 2 pi f tau into x of f, right? Is it okay? The Fourier transform for this, right? Now I want to know what is my h of f. Yeah, what is your h of f in this? What is frequency response of this LTI system?
1 plus
y of 1 plus
e to the power of minus j
1 plus e power, yeah, minus j 2 pi f tau, right? It's a frequency response of my system. And I want to know the magnitude response of that one. Then this will be mod 1 plus e power minus j 2 pi f tau. For example, let me consider tau equals to 1 millisecond. 1 millisecond means 10 power minus 3 seconds. Okay, how to simplify this? Suppose if I take this component common, tau by 2, then I am going to get e power j 2 pi f tau by 2 plus e power minus j 2 pi f tau by 2. If I take this part common, otherwise you can multiply. This one into this one is 1. And this one to this one is same as e power minus j 2 pi f tau. I am rewriting this in another form, that's it. And what is mod ab? Can I write like this? Or any mistake is there? Mod ab equals to mod a into mod b. Is it true? See, this is always true.
Yes, sir.
Mod ab equals to mod a into mod b. If you have doubt, you can simply write like this. R1 e power j theta 1. This b like in polar form, if they are complex. R2 e power j theta 2. Now I can write like mod R1 R2 e power j into theta 1 plus theta 2. This one I can write like this, right? This is just a magnitude. This is always positive. Or this is always some non-negative quantity. I can take this non-negative quantity and real quantity out of this mod. Then I am going to get R1 R2 mod e power j theta 1 plus theta 2 means 1. Mod e power j theta is always 1, right? Into 1. That's it. Where R1 corresponds to mod A, R2 corresponds to mod B. Similarly, I can write mod of this one into mod of this. And magnitude of this one is 1. 1 into. Then what is the mod of this? See, if I do divided by 2 and into 2, then what will happen to this part? What is this?
It's in the form of cos theta.
In the form of cos theta, right? Then you are going to have 1 into 2 mod cos 2 pi f tau by 2, right? Cos 2 pi f tau by 2. Finally, we are going to get something like this. 2 mod cos 2 pi f tau by 2. For example, when my excess delay for the second path is 1 millisecond, in such scenarios, mod cos 2 pi f into 10 power minus 3 divided by 2. See my frequency response of the system. Let's try to plot this frequency response from f equal to 0 hertz to f in hertz, 0 hertz to 1 kilohertz. Let's say I want to plot from the two points. Then what is this value at 0, f0? At f equal to 0, what is the gain? At f0, 2 into cos 0. What is cos 0? Cos 0, right? Yeah. This is 2. Then the gain of my system is 2 at frequency 0. And after that, this will decrease, right? Cos theta will decrease as theta increases from 0 to up to what point? At least 0 to pi by 2, that will decrease, right? At pi by 2, that will become 0. After that, that is negative. Now, can you guess what is happening to this at 1 kilohertz? At f equal to 1 kilohertz, what is this value?
0.
Oh, is it 0 at 1 kilohertz?
Cos pi.
Yeah, cos pi.
Minus 1, sir.
Minus
what is
1.
Mod?
Yes. Mod means 1, right? Okay, when this will be 0? When this will be 0? This should be pi by 2, right? This should be equal to pi by 2. When that will be pi by 2? This will be equal to pi by 2 when f equal to 1 by 2 into 10 power minus 3. It means f should be 0.5 kilohertz. At 0.5 kilohertz, that will be 0, right? At 0.5 kilohertz, that will be 0. See 0.5 kilohertz, and this is negative actually after that, but due to this modulus, this will go like this. And once again, this is 2 at this point. I just plotted from 0 to 1 kilohertz. I'm not plotting beyond that one. You just you can do it later. No need to worry about this. Just I want to see what's happening to my frequencies between 0 to 1 kilohertz. That's part of my plan. I want to know what's happening to those frequency components due to this multipath effect, channel effect. It's something like a filter, right? Yeah.
Rectifier.
No, this is not a rectifier. See, this is not your time domain waveform. It's a gain, right? Gain in the frequency domain. For example, if I ask what is the gain at frequency 0.5 kilohertz, means zero gain, right? Suppose my input frequency to this channel is 0.5 kilohertz is the input, and I won't receive nothing, right? Is it true or false? In this particular example, with tau equal to 1 millisecond, if my input is this one, cos 2 pi ft, where f equals to 0.5 kilohertz into 10 power 3, then what will be output I am going to receive? You can see this channel response or channel gain, right, at this frequency. You might have seen this, right? In frequency domain, there is multiplication. Y of f equals to h of f into x of f. Time domain, that is convolution, right? LTA system. Each half f into x half f. Gain at 0.5 kilohertz for this particular channel when tau equals to 1 millisecond is 0 gain. That means that signal will be multiplied by 0. This will be nullified. If my input frequency, input signal contains 0.5 kHz frequency component, that will be nullified due to this destructive addition. There are two paths in this, right? I am trying to add two signals. Y of t equals to cos 2 pi f t plus cos 2 pi f into t minus tau. These two are getting cancelled out. These two are getting cancelled out when f equals to 0.5 kHz in this example. Due to are getting cancelled out. And I am receiving nothing, right? Due to that cancellation. Because they are adding destructively, destructive addition. And what happens to this? Is it constructive or destructive? This addition. Or this 1 kilohertz. Forget about this. Just think about 1 kilohertz. Is constructive addition or destructive addition?
Constructive, sir.
Constructive, right? Because both are getting added. In that scenario, when f equal to 1 kilohertz, what's happening is the two are getting added. I am going to get two times this. That's what I am getting, right? If you want to have proper mathematical reasoning for this, let me consider this one to be 10 power minus 3, right? 1 millisecond. And if I consider f equal to 1 kilohertz, what I am going to get is, I'll try to split this into two parts. That inner part can be written like this, 2 pi f t minus 2 pi f tau. This is not function of time, right? This is function of time, t time. This is just some constant delay. If tau equal to 10 power minus 3, then for f equal to 1 kilohertz, 10 power 3, these two are getting cancelled out. Then I am going to get 2 pi. My phase is 2 pi. Cos 2 pi ft minus 2 pi. Cos theta minus 2 pi is same as cos theta, right? Cos theta, this is something like theta of t. Cos theta of t minus 2 pi is same as cos theta of t. I am going to get once again same thing. Those two are getting added, right? Constructive addition, because phase shift of 2 pi leads to constructive addition. Suppose f equal to 0.5 kilohertz, then what's happening is, if this is 0.5 kilohertz means 1 by 2 into 10 power 3, right? This 2 gets cancelled out. I'm going to get minus pi. Cos 2 by ft minus pi. What is cos theta minus pi? Is it cos theta or minus cos theta?
Minus cos theta.
Minus cos theta, right? Here theta is nothing but 2 pi ft. Theta of t. Function of time, right? This is already cos theta of t. This one is cos theta of t minus pi. This is nothing but minus cos theta of t. These two are getting cancelled out, the destructive addition. It means some frequency components are added constructively. Some frequency components are added destructively. That's what happening due to this just multipath, right? It's something like a filter, right? It's trying to filter out some frequency components. For example, these components are having very, very low gain. You can consider this like some sort of stop band. You can consider this part like pass band. You can consider this part like pass band, right? It's trying to do some sort of filtering. Trying to behave like a filter, right? Now we got intuition of filters. See, the same thing can be, these kind of filters can be implementable with the help of digital systems just by introducing delay, right? Just for that intuition, I explained this one to you. If I go to digital domain, I can simply replace this with NTS, right? Where TS equals 1 by FS. I can replace this with NTS. I can simply try to apply delay in digital with the help of registers, shift registers, like D flip flops or something else. Artificially, you can try to generate such kind of multipass by using digital systems. That's a benefit I am going to get. Artificially, I can introduce, right? With the help of delay systems, the delay components. Yes, let's go back to this. If I have already shared to you, right? Linear combination of sinusoidal signals. Let's have a look into this. Sum of two sinusoidal signals with same frequency but different phases. Okay, what you are observing in this? Let's have a look into this one. This first plot. What we are doing here is sine 2 pi ft plus sine 2 pi ft minus pi by 4. Same signal with a phase shift of pi by 4. We are trying to add these two signals where f equal to 1 kilohertz. This blue color corresponds to sine 2 pi ft. Red color corresponds to sine 2 pi ft with phase shift of pi by 4. And this yellow color corresponds to sum of those two signals after adding those two signals. Yes, what's happening here in this? Is it constructive addition or destructive addition? See, constructive addition means, yeah, just for your reference, I am telling this blind thing. Let me consider this is my signal x of t. This is my delayed version of that one. Due to that excess delay tau, I got some phase shift of pi by 4. Like that, you can think. It's excess phase due to that delay. Because this something equivalent to minus 2 pi f tau. Minus 2 pi f tau equals to minus pi by 4. Like that, you can think. Is it constructive or destructive? After adding this component, if this amplitude is increasing, then that is constructive. If that is amplitude is decreasing, then that is destructive. Like that, you can think. Is it constructive or destructive?
Constructive, sir.
Constructive, right? Because after adding these two signals, this amplitude, peak to peak amplitude is increasing, right? The constructive addition. But you may not get exactly equal to 2. This is something less than 2. It's not equal to 2. When can you expect equal to 2? This should be 2 pi, right? When instead of pi by 4 phase shift, this is 2 pi phase shift, then you are going to get 2. Exactly constructive, perfect constructive, right? Okay. This is for 2 kilohertz signal. Same thing, sine 2 pi ft plus sine 2 pi ft minus pi by 4 with frequency 2 kilohertz. Is it constructive or destructive? Blue color is sine 2 pi ft. Red color corresponds to with phase shift pi by 4. Yellow color corresponds to sum of both. Is it constructive or destructive?
This is also constructive, sir.
Yeah, this is also constructive, right? This is also constructive. And both are almost same level, right? This peak to peak value is same as this peak to peak value. Both are exactly identical. The gain for this system and the gain for this system, both are same. When the phase is same, minus pi by 4 phase shift for both of them. This is 1 kilohertz, this is 2 kilohertz. When the phase is same, then you are going to get same gain. Same mod h of f for both of them. And this is with the phase shift of minus pi by 2. Yellow color corresponds to sum of both. Once again, this is constructive. Once again, this is constructive because this is above 1. This value is more than 1. This is constructive. Similarly, 2 kilohertz is also constructive with the phase shift of minus pi by 2. and the gain you are going to get in both cases is same. There is no difference. And if you go for minus 3 pi by 4 phase shift for the second component, is it constructive or destructive? Yellow color
constructive
output. Yeah. What is that? Constructive or destructive?
It is destructive, sir.
Destructive, right? Because this is less than 1. This value is less than 1, right? This peak value. It's reducing. This is destructive addition. Once again, this is destructive addition, and both are having same gain. When the phase is same, the gain we are going to get also same for those two frequencies also. And when the phase is minus pi, this excess phase we are going to get is minus pi in both scenarios. In this case, this is totally destructive. They are getting cancelled out. Sin 2 pi ft minus sin 2 pi ft. Because sin 2 pi ft minus pi is same as minus sin 2 pi ft. These two are getting cancelled out. And it's totally nullified, right? It's zero, yellow. You can see this one. It's a destructive addition. It means for some phase shifts, there is constructive addition. For some phase shifts, there is some destructive addition of those components, right? It means for when you are having multi-path in your channel, for some of the phase shifts, you are going to get gain more than 1. For some of the phase shifts, you are going to get gain less than 1, right? But I am talking about second component phase shift with respect to first one. And this is similarly, you can see later. Now, till now we discussed regarding phases. What I had done till now is I constructed a signal sin 2 pi ft. F might be 1 kHz or 2 kHz, whatever you want. My second component I am considering like sin 2 pi ft minus theta, where theta is some constant phase shift. That's what I had done till now. Now let's go for delay instead of phase shift. And one more observation we have seen till now is when the phase shift is same for those two frequency components, then the gain introduced by the channel also same for both, right? Both are getting constructive or both are getting destructive addition, right? That's what we have seen for those 1 kHz and 2 kHz. Now let's have a look into delay instead of phase shift. This is sin 2 pi f into t minus tau d. T minus tau d means delayed by tau d seconds. Delayed by tau d seconds. For example, delayed by 0.1 milliseconds, 0.25 milliseconds. This yellow color corresponds to delayed by 0.25 milliseconds. And this red color corresponds to delayed by 0.1 milliseconds, where f equal to 1 kHz. F equal to 1 kHz means time period of this wave is 1 milliseconds, right? This is just for your reference. You can look into that later. Now I am trying to add these two signals, sin 2 pi ft and sin 2 pi f into t minus tau d. Am I getting the same gain or different gains for these two?
Same, sir.
Is it same gain? Okay, I'll tell that. Okay, this is fixed one, right? Yeah, this is not 2 kHz. The overall thing is for 1 kHz only. Let me give briefly about this. This red color one corresponds to tau d equals to 0.15 milliseconds. This red color is tau d equals to 0.15 millisecond. In this case, this is more than 1. This peak value is more than 1. Then this is constructive addition, right? Constructive addition. What is the concerned phase shift? when tau d equals to 0.15 milliseconds. Can you just tell me what is the constant phase shift for this? Try to split this into two parts.
2 pi f tau d.
Yeah, minus 2 pi f tau d, right? This then f equal to 10 power 3 and tau d equals to 0.5 milliseconds. Then what will be that one? Two pi into 10 power 3 into 0.15 into 10 power minus 3. That 10 power 3 gets cancelled out. Then we are going to get 0.15 into 2 pi. It means 0.3 pi. For 0.3 pi phase shift, we are going to get constructive addition. You can map to that earlier one, that instead of delay, that phase shift we considered, right? And this is with tau d equals to 0.25 milliseconds. With tau d equals to 0.25 milliseconds, this yellow color, still this is more than one constructive addition. And try to convert this into phase, and you can map to that earlier one. And this is this, yeah, this color corresponds to tau d equals to 0.45 milliseconds. This is destructive addition. This is less than one, destructive addition. And the concerned phase shift we are having is 2 pi into 0.45. 2 pi into 0.45 means 0.9 pi. 0.9 pi is the extra phase shift we are having with respect to this one, relative phase shift. And this is giving destructive addition. And similarly, you can have a look into this one, 0.5, 0.75 milliseconds and 1 millisecond. Now let's have comparison between 1 kilohertz and 2 kilohertz. Let's try to fix the delay. Sin 2 pi ft plus sin 2 pi f into t minus tau d. Same thing for this also. And delay for both of them is same. 0.125 milliseconds, 0.125 milliseconds for both of them. For 1 kilohertz signal, sum of these two things is yellow colored one. Is it constructive or destructive?
Constructive, sir.
Still constructive, right? This is almost nearby 2. This is more than 1, right? The constructive addition. And what about this one? Is it constructive or destructive? This is for 2 kilohertz. This is also constructive. You can see this is more than 1. This level is almost 1. This is 1 actually. This red color or this blue color, that level is 1. It's above that level, right? It's more than 1. It is still constructive. But which one is having more gain? 1 kilohertz or 2 kilohertz? Yeah, which one is having more gain after this multipath addition?
With less frequency?
No, at least, yeah, we can't generalize that one. One thing we can say is 1 kilohertz signal is having high gain as compared to 2 kilohertz signal in this case. Because, see, we can't generalize that one because that will fluctuate. We may get like this. That gain response might be like this, some sort of comp kind of thing. Some of the high frequency components also may have high gain. Some of the low frequency components also may have high gain. It will fluctuate as well. Some sort of comp kind of thing, like this. At least you can compare these two things. The gain of 2 kilohertz frequency is a bit less compared to gain of 1 kilohertz frequency. Why? My delay is constant for both, right? I am applying same delay for both of them. Then why am I getting high gain for this and low gain for this? What is the reason? Is the phase shift same for both of them?
No.
What is the phase shift for this? First one. This is 2 pi f into tau d. where tau d equals to 0.125 into 10 power minus 3. F equal to 10 power 3, right? 10 power 3, 10 power minus 3 gets cancelled out. Then I am going to get 2 pi into 0.125. 2 pi into 0.125 means?
0.25 pi.
Yeah, 0.25 pi, right? And this one corresponds to 0.5 pi. Second one. Because this is twice the frequency, right? Two times this frequency. This is 2 kilohertz. This is 0.25 pi. This is 0.5 pi. Both are having different phase shifts, right? Even though they are having the same delay. That's the reason we are getting unequal gain for both of them. And yeah, you can understand it very clearly from this. Now the delay is 0.25 milliseconds. This is 1 kilohertz. This is 2 kilohertz. Yellow color corresponds to sum in both of them. Is it constructive or destructive addition? This one.
Constructive, sir.
Constructive, right? Because this gain is above 1. And what about this? It's totally destructive in nature, right? The second one. Because both are getting cancelled out and you got 0. This yellow colored one. The reason is, if tau d equals to 0.25 milliseconds, the phase we are going to get is 2 pi f means 10 power 3 into 0.25 into 10 power minus 3. Then 2 pi into 0.25. 2 pi into 0.25 means 0.5 pi, right? You see, pi by 2. Pi by 2 phase shift. And what is the phase shift introduced by this? Second one. Into 2 times, right? Because see, 2 pi f into tau d. In this case, f is 2 kilohertz. In this case, f equal to 1 kilohertz. 2 times this one, right? If you do this simplification, we are going to end up with minus pi phase shift. This is minus pi by 2 phase shift. This is minus pi phase shift. And we have already seen sine 2 pi ft minus 2 minus pi equal to minus sine 2 pi ft. These two are getting cancelled out. Totally destructive. Even though they are having same delay, in terms of phase shift, they are unequal in nature, right? When the frequency components are different. And that is responsible for some frequency components to be constructive and some frequency components to be destructive in nature. We just analyzed only multipath channel with two multipaths, that's it, right? One is line of sight path, another one is some reflected path. Very basic level system, we analyze it till now. It's not so complicated, very, very basic level. Even that very, very basic level system also behaving like some sort of a filter, right? Some frequency components are getting high gain, some frequency components are getting low gain. That means, again, feel like some frequency components are falling in stop band and some frequency components are falling in pass band. Due to constructive addition, some frequency components are falling in pass band, and due to destructive addition, some frequency components are falling in stop band. Stop band means low gain region. Like that you can think. You can imagine some sort of like a filter, right? Filtering behavior. These kind of intuitions you can carry forward to digital systems. While designing your digital filters, you will try to apply such kind of logics only. With the help of delay systems, you will try to introduce some sort of filters, or you will try to design some sort of filters. Digital filters. Yeah, we can have a look into that remaining part as part of assignment. And I'll try to briefly explain what we are going to study in our course, digital signal processing course. This is our syllabus for digital signal processing course, EC3103 code. It's a course code for our college, digital signal processing. Okay, some of you, can you please explain something about these topics? At least you might have studied somewhere in signals and systems, right? mostly there is
Sir.
equivalence between both. Yeah. Okay, introduction to DSP, that will, yeah, we are already doing the same thing, and some applications of digital signal processing. Then representation of signals on orthogonal basis. Have you seen this earlier in signals and systems course, this topic?
No, sir.
Orthogonal basis is nothing but we have already studied. For example, Fourier series. If we have a look into that Fourier series expansion, those functions are orthogonal functions. You are writing something like x of t equals to, when that is periodic signal, x of t equal to sigma ak e power j 2 pi k into some f naught t, like that you are writing, right? Those are orthogonal frequency components. You are having some sum of harmonics, right? Linear combination of harmonic functions. And those harmonic functions are orthogonal to each other over that interval 0 to t. Those are called as orthogonal basis functions in that Fourier series case. Yeah, you have already studied there, but you might have known this term. This is the term related to that one. They are orthogonal to each other. Based on that orthogonality property only, you are able to find those coefficients, A1, A2, A3, and those coefficients. Because if you do inner product, you can get the coefficient, right? Yeah, if you want to have clarity over that, let me have something. Can someone tell me, yeah, what is the expansion, the Fourier series expansion roughly, when there is a periodic signal with period t? Yes, what is this? Or you might be studying like capital omega naught. Earlier you might have used this notation, but I already said that for analog we'll go for capital omega notation, f naught into kt or k into omega naught t, like this you might have studied. And then what will be my ak? How to find my this coefficient? 1 by t integral. Yeah, you can fill this gap. What should be this? Yeah, one of you can respond. What is AK? X of t. For example, this is over duration t. This can be 0 to t, or this can be minus t by 2 to t by t. Like that. Any continuous duration t, x of t into e power minus j 2 pi f naught k into t. And if I simply substitute this expression into this x of t, then what I am going to get is everything else will be nullified due to that orthogonality property. For example, you might have studied in linear algebra course, the vectors x bar and y bar are orthogonal when the dot product is zero. Then x bar, y bar are orthogonal. Similarly, when coming to functions, if you do this integration, this function, that function, the complex conjugate of that function, and if you integrate that one, if you got zero, then those are called as orthogonal functions. If you substitute this into this expression and if you expand that one, only the term corresponds to AK. That kth term will be remained and all other terms will be nullified. If you do that integration for the remaining terms, just expand this and do that one. Due to the orthogonal property, they are getting nullified. Only this term will be left over finally, AK term. That coefficient you can get with this. Okay, that is fine. Thereafter, as this is a digital signal processing course, we will try to see how to convert analog signals into digital format. For that, we need to do sampling. After sampling, we need to go for encoding, followed by you can apply to some digital system for processing that digital data. That's what we are going to do. During that process, we'll try to learn sampling and reconstruction, because most of the real-time signals are analog in nature, right? By nature, for example, speech signal or that picture or anything. Almost every signal in the nature are analog in nature. If you want to process that with the help of digital signal processor, first we need to convert into digital format. For that, we need to study how to convert that into digital format with the help of sampling followed by encoder, quantization encoder like that. After that, finally, we are expecting our output also to be analog in nature for most of the applications. Finally, I want to get back to my actual analog signal somehow. That's what my plan. In such scenario, you need to reconstruct that analog signal back, right? With the help of digital to analog converter. Yes, I think we will try to look into later. Yeah. And these are some of the topics: discrete system attributes and representation of system with difference equations and impulse response calculation. LSI systems. See, this is nothing but LTA system. LTA means linear time invariant system. LSI means linear shift invariant system. That time replaced with shift. Time delay or some shift. Both are similar, right, in nature. The shift can be applied to spatial domain also, the two-dimensional images also. That's why we are going for general time. Instead of time, we are replacing with shift. That's it. And cyclic convolution with some example. See, whatever you have studied in your signals and systems course, that corresponds to linear convolution. In addition to that linear convolution, we are going to study cyclic convolution. We'll have to see the importance of this also. And second unit corresponds to frequency domain analysis. It means unit one roughly corresponds to converting analog to digital format in an effective manner, and how to reconstruct back to our analog signal. That's what plan in unit one. And unit two corresponds to frequency domain analysis of those discrete time signals or those digital signals. Something similar to your signals and systems course. Okay, in signals and systems course, which transform you used for periodic signals and which transform used for aperiodic signals? Yes, you can.
Laplace transform for aperiodic.
Aperiodic signal, Fourier transform, right? Yeah, continuous time Fourier transform is for aperiodic signals. Aperiodic means the signals which are not periodic. And for periodic signals, Fourier series, right? If you want to analyze that periodic signals, you'll try to convert that into Fourier series. If you want, you can apply Fourier transform to that Fourier series expanded signal. That's possible. After converting into Fourier series expansion, you can apply Fourier transform to that one with the help of impulse functions. For example, what the Fourier transform for e power j 2 pi f1t? If you apply Fourier transform for that one, you are going to get delta of f minus f1 with the help of special function called as analog impulse. You can do that one, but you should convert that periodic signal to some Fourier series expansion format. After that, you can apply Fourier transform to that expansion with the help of these special functions, impulse functions. Suppose they are unstable systems. If they are unstable, what kind of transforms you can use?
Laplace transform.
Okay, you can go for Laplace transform, right? Similarly, for our digital case, we are having such things. This discrete time Fourier transform, something similar to your continuous time Fourier transform. This is for aperiodic signals. And thereafter, this is for periodic signals, DFT, discrete Fourier transform. And thereafter some properties of this. That's fine. And we'll study Z transforms. Is something in place of Fourier Laplace transform. In order to understand unstable system behaviors, we need to go through Z transform analysis. This is something similar to your Laplace transform in your signals and systems course. There you have studied R versus, right? Region of convergence in Laplace transform. Similarly, you'll try to study region of convergence and some other properties. And one extra thing we are going to study is fast Fourier transform. Fast Fourier transform means this is one of the algorithm to compute DFT, discrete Fourier transform, with less time. I will try to compute discrete Fourier transform with the help of my system, right? With the help of processor and some memory combination. I'll try to find this discrete Fourier transform. This is one of the algorithm which will try to compute this DFT in less time. I want to do everything in less time, right? I want to process my data in less time. This is one of such algorithms. We'll try to study that also. And unit 3 corresponds to digital filter design. Digital filters and finite wavelength effects. We'll try to look into some of the basic digital filter design in this one and try to analyze in the frequency domain. These concepts will be very much helpful there. Whatever we studied till now, that multipath addition is there, right? Similar thing we can try to do when coming to that FIR systems, finite impulse response systems. We'll try to see that later. And unit 4 corresponds to digital filter structures. Digital filter structures means once we have frequency response of the system with that, we need to implement that with the help of some memory devices that shift registers are there, right? I said like with the help of delay elements, we'll try to implement that one. And what kind of components we can use, everything. And the structures, how to implement that transfer function, we'll try to study in this unit. It's implementation perspective, this unit. How to implement that mathematical expression. That's what our plan in this. And thereafter, some infinite impulse response digital filters will try to study. Yeah, this also will come under filter design, but we'll try to learn rigorously in this unit about filter design. And that's part of our syllabus. And these are the course outcomes you are going to get at the end of the course. Yeah, thank you. Do you have any doubts? Yeah, any doubts?